I want to welcome all the delegates and to say we are just doing a sound check and we'll go. As you can see, Honorable Chief Minister is already with us and we have everybody here. We're just waiting for a sound check and then we'll go straight into the program. Just bear with us. Thank you so much.
Now it is open. Can you hear us now, Ajay?
Yes, we can hear you. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, sir. Yes, we can.
Oh, fine.
So, Honorable Chief Minister, with your permission, we'll start. Is that okay with you?
Okay.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon and welcome to all of you, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Industry Minister, my dear friend Nisha, who's in Washington bright and early, and of course, good friend Gaurav and the fellow panelists. Welcome to the opening session of the 7th National Forum of PAFI. Sir, we are delighted to have Karnataka as a partner state. This is a first for us. For the first time, we have a partner state at this national forum, and we are really privileged to have Karnataka and you all at this opening session. Sir, as we speak, this is no longer a national forum. I think we should call it an international forum because you are being watched from all over the world. Delegates have checked in from Europe, from the US, from Far East, and we are indeed privileged to have such a large audience attending your session, sir. Sir, we are delighted that you as the captain of the Karnataka team is with us along with your excellent team. I have had my personal experience from the Jubilant Bhartiya Group of excellent relationship and guidance from all of you. And we are actually going to be expanding our investments in Karnataka. And I'm so delighted to have all of you come to this session. I'm going to request Rahul Sharma, past president of PAFI, to take over from here. Over to you, Rahul.
Thank you, Ajay. Thank you. Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Minister, Mr. Gupta, Principal Secretary, Industries, it is our pleasure at PAFI to welcome you all at the opening session of the 7th Forum. Karnataka is a crucial state as we look at building trust between the industry and the government and work towards making sure that the challenges that we face are taken care of. Karnataka does not only host a technology hub for the country, but has also given birth to a lot of sectoral advances in the past few decades. And we would love to hear all about those from you, Honorable Chief Minister, because we know that there is so much happening in Karnataka that needs to be shared with all our delegates who, like Ajay said, have joined us from across the world. So I'll very quickly now invite Nisha Biswal, who is the head of USIVC, to make a few comments before we move ahead with this session. Thank you. Nisha, could you please?
Thank you so much, Rahul. Good afternoon to all of you and a wonderful welcome to the Honorable Chief Minister. It's so wonderful to be here with you, sir. We, US India Business Council, are very good not only on the U.S.-India corridor, but the very important role that the state of Karnataka plays within that corridor. USIVC has been around for a very long time, 45 years, in fact, to this year when we were founded by the request of both governments to support trade and investment in the U.S.-India corridor. But of course, 2020 has been a year like no other in our 45-year history. With the impact of the global coronavirus pandemic, we've seen not only the dramatic impact on health, but also the dramatic impact on the global economy and on the Indian economy. And yet, we are starting to think about what the post-pandemic economic opportunities look like. We're very focused on the resilience of the Indian economy and how, as global supply chains are starting to reevaluate and think about de-risking and diversification, the opportunities that India represents. And it's in that context that just a few short weeks ago, we held a Destination Karnataka event with the Honorable Chief Minister and the Principal Secretary to really highlight how Karnataka has played such a critically important role in India in advancing the knowledge economy, but also going well beyond the knowledge economy and the service sector and looking at so many other sectors as well. And as we think about what the post-COVID world looks like, we know that the state of Karnataka is going to be a leading harbinger of the opportunity that India will seek to capitalize on for its industry, but most importantly, for its workers and its citizens. And so as we think about rebuilding the economy, rebuilding our societies, and making them more resilient for the future, organizations like PAFI, which have played such an important role in supporting the advocacy and public policy environment that will support greater investment, and partnerships with states like Karnataka, which are going to lead the way not only for the service sector and the knowledge sector, but also for critical sectors in manufacturing. I think that this conference at this time is a great opportunity to further explore, and I'm really delighted that we are able to participate and be a partner with PAFI in this undertaking. The U.S. India Business Council again welcomes the opportunity to flow greater investment into the U.S.-India corridor, and in particular into the great state of Karnataka. It's really my privilege to be able to turn the podium over to the government of Karnataka and to the Honorable Chief Minister, who has done just an extraordinarily magnificent job in leading that state and in driving economic growth in Karnataka and for the people of Karnataka. So I'm going to hand it back over to you for the Ajay, for the formal introduction of the Chief Minister, but I just want to again welcome the Honorable Chief Minister today.
Thank you.
Rahul, introduce Martha. You can introduce Parcha Martha.
Rahul, over to you.
Rahul.
Yeah. Honorable Chief Minister.
Introduce Martha.
No.
Parcha Martha. Parcha Martha.
No. Nishat, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for your words. And I'd like to now request Honorable Chief Minister to share his views with us and comments with us, and talk to us a little bit about his state and all the good stuff that is happening there. Honorable Chief Minister, the podium is yours.
Shri Ajay Khanna, Forum Chairman and Co-founder PAFI, Rahul Sharma, First President and Founding Member PAFI, Nisha Biswe, President, USIBC, Gaurav Gupta, our Principal Secretary, Commerce and Industry Department, and Mr. Jagdish Shetter, Industry Minister, and all the dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen present in the meeting. I am happy to address the PFI 7th National Forum 2020 virtual meet today. These are challenging times, and my government is taking stringent measures to fight the coronavirus and keep the economy going. Karnataka government is working to ensure that the lives and livelihood of citizens are protected and the investment climate of the state remains strong. Keeping the investor-centered approach our government has launched the new industrial policy 2020-25 to build a prosperous Karnataka and create jobs for the youth. Karnataka has also been the first state in the entire country to launch amendment to Industrial Facilitation Act, with which the industry would not need any statutory permissions for the first 3 years, enabling their projects get off the ground faster. Sir, in 2020, Karnataka has attracted investment worth 1.38 lakh crores, the highest in the country, which would create 70,000 direct employment in the state. Over the last few months, labor laws have been simplified, flexible working hours, nighttime working hours for women, relaxing overtime, easier filling of returns, etc. Karnataka is the hub in ITES service in the country. Recently, our government has approved new information technology IT policy 2020-25, which would help the state in increasing the state share in the goal of a trillion dollar digital economy for India, to promote the nascent startup industry ecosystem. Our government has passed landmark legislation creating Karnataka Innovation Authority, which would enable regulating sandboxes, facilitating innovation. I want that PFI for creating this wonderful platform, and like to assure all of you, sir, that my government will provide full support for any business in the state. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honorable Chief Minister, for your very encouraging words. I think it's important that the industry is hearing you and will be responding to all the good things that are happening in the state. Could I now request the Honorable Minister to share his views with us, please?
Honorable Chief Minister, Sri V.S. Yeddyurappaji, Ajay Khanna, Forum Chairman and Co-founder, PAFI, Rahul Sharmaji, Nisha Biswalji, Gaurav Guptaji, and all the dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen present in the meeting. It gives me immense pleasure to address PAFI's stellar gathering at the 7th National Forum 2020, Building Trust, Charting Growth virtual meet today. I am honored and privileged to be with all of you today while speaking about the emerging economic challenges and the impact of the ongoing pandemic. The government of Karnataka is focusing on enhancing the ease of doing business in the state. Ladies and gentlemen, Karnataka is one of the biggest states in southern India, and is known for ITES services, machine tooling, manufacturing, aerospace, biotechnology, and engineering design. Karnataka is among one of the first states to lift the lockdown gradually and restart economic activities. The state, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, has undertaken several visionary reforms to review the industrial growth and made it easy to do business in Karnataka. We have simplified processes, set up single window for investors, and engaged in regular discussion with the industry to create a stable, policy-driven environment. Over the last few months, labor laws have been simplified, as these measures were long overdue to attract investment to the state. Recent reforms have projected India's standing in the World Bank ease of doing business, ranking to 63rd globally, the top ranked country in the South Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, the state has made not only significant stride in the reforms, but also undertook several visionary reforms to revive the industrial growth and made it easy to do business in Karnataka. Our government has also launched the new industrial policy 2020-25 to build a prosperous Karnataka and create jobs for the youth. The government aims to create 20 lakh jobs during the industrial policy 2020-25 in various sectors. Another milestone was Karnataka Industries Facilitation Act 2002 was enacted to provide for the promotion of industrial development and facilitation of new investments to simplify the regulatory framework. It is of its first kind in the entire nation. We implemented this of ease of doing business in regarding formalities and rules regarding the starting of the industry. To further simplify the procedure for establishment of the industries in the state, Karnataka Industry Facilitation Amendment Ordinance Act 2020 provides an initial exemption from obtaining the pre-operative clearance for a period of 3 years or till the date of commercial operation. The state provides state high-level clearance committee, state-level single window clearance committee, and district-level single window clearance committee constituted under the Act. Recently, Bengaluru has been included in the country ranking mechanism by DPIIT in coordination with the World Bank as a part of World Banking Doing Business Reports 2020, along with Mumbai, Delhi and Kolkata. The state is committed to bringing ease to regulatory compliances of businesses and has started an ambitious program for reforms in partnership with departments and various stakeholders to make it easier, simpler and quicker for businesses to start and operate in the state. I sincerely believe one such great opportunity to make Karnataka a more vital hub of investment and build a robust industrialized economy that will set a benchmark for other states in the country. I am sure we will all soon emerge out of this challenging situation stronger and healthier. I urge you all to stay strong and stay safe. Thank you, PAFI, for allowing me to address this forum. I look forward to working with you in the future. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Minister. It was indeed great to hear all the steps that Karnataka is taking and your ministry is making it easier for the industry to do business in Karnataka. We will obviously look forward to being in touch with you as we go forward. Thank you once again, Honorable Minister. Could I now request Principal Secretary Sri Gupta to share his views with us, please?
So it's a very good morning to people in US and good afternoon to all around people all around us. Honorable Chief Minister sir, Honorable Industries Minister sir, friends from the PFI, Ms. Nisha Biswal, and all dignitaries and delegates. It's my honor and privilege to be part of this insightful session with Honorable Chief Minister and the friends from PAFI. It's indeed been a privilege to know that for the last 10 years, Public Affairs Foundation of India has been working on various aspects of reaching out to the government and industry leaders in order to facilitate industry, trade and business. We all know that our lives have been interrupted this year, perhaps in an unprecedented manner by the COVID-19 pandemic. We have talked in various fora and talked about various steps that have been taken by Karnataka to address the hurdles and obstacles because of this coronavirus. I am indeed proud that under the leadership of Honorable Chief Minister, Karnataka from the day one has been able to help industries to not only revive and sustain, but also to implement various policies in order to protect their people, their workers, and also to ensure their economic revival and growth. COVID period has also been a forum for us for ensuring that we have a relook at our policies, which have been there for quite a long period of time, but the Honorable Chief Minister and the State Cabinet has approved the industrial policy recently, and we have also had a very, very deep look at the ecosystem of the land laws, making it easier to buy land, making it easier to facilitate compliances to the labor laws, and also several other initiatives, including the Industries Facilitation Act, which Honorable Minister just now referred to. So it's been indeed a great experience for us to work with the industry. Collaborating with industry bodies is an important task of what we do. I think interaction today with PAFI to understand the needs of the industry and to augment the ecosystem is an objective that we are working at. So engaging with the international community also is a part of what we do. Every other day we are interacting with the world community. Today there was interaction with Taiwan. There have been in various interactions with US, with Germany, with France and Netherlands, a number of other countries. We would like more and more integration with the global value chain, localizing the supply chains around Karnataka, and to identify new lines of business in which people are looking at China plus one strategy. So we have been working actively with the electronics, with the toys, with the pharma, the textiles, agriculture implements, white goods, fast-moving consumer goods, and a number of other industries to see that how we can harness their potential in order to further the economic growth of the country. So I would also like to mention that if you are looking into the future of harnessing the energies of AI, IoT, in order to drive Industry 4.0, that is also an integral part of our industrial policy. And would like to conclude by saying that we look forward to more and more interaction with the members of the PAFI, and looking to build and rebuild the economy of our mutual countries, and to understand which are the areas that we can mutually work on. So thank you very much for giving an opportunity today. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The PAFI can assure you of its support to Karnataka and whatever Karnataka is doing. A lot of our members and a lot of delegates who are part of the conference today have strong connections with Karnataka or would like to make in the state, given what the state has to offer. So yeah, I mean, you would probably hear a lot more from us and look forward to continuing to work together. Could I now ask Nisha? She had some questions. If she would like to raise a couple of questions with Mr. Gupta, and then we can take it from there. Nisha, floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Rahul. And it was really fantastic to hear such a clear and crisp vision for Karnataka from the Honorable Chief Minister, the Minister, and from the Principal Secretary. We also had the privilege of participating in a roundtable discussion between the state of Karnataka and the state of Colorado here in the United States just a couple of weeks ago. And I think, again, that outreach and forging of connections between the states and cities of the United States and India, and really deepening that economic corridor, I think is going to be resulting in greater two-way investment. Principal Secretary, you know, we talked about how Karnataka has become such a knowledge hub for India, and that there is such incredible growth in the service sector and in particularly technology. Can you elaborate a little bit on how Karnataka is taking steps to ensure that there is a growing pool of skilled workers to fuel that growth as you look to draw more and more investment into your state?
I think we've lost the connection.
We lose the chief minister.
Maybe we should, Gaurav, can you please ask them to log in again?
Right, sir.
Well, I can just say that they gave a very impressive talk about how they're focusing on education and skilling, and that there's been I don't have to speak for them. I think there we have the CM's office again. Did you hear my question, Principal Secretary? And do you want to talk a little bit about how you're investing in skilling to attract investment and support industry? I think you're on mute.
You are on mute, Ms. Gupta.
I think it's the same issue again.
We can hear you now. We can hear,
we can hear you now.
Yes.
Yeah. So I think we lost you for a minute or so. Nisha, I'm so sorry. And if I may ask for just a concise re-presentation of your
My point was that Karnataka has become such a knowledge hub. And as we look at future economic growth and investment coming from the technology sector, how is the state of Karnataka preparing to invest in the skilled workforce that will support that growing knowledge economy?
Now, indeed, skilling is very important. Let me start by saying that Karnataka, and within that the capital of Bangalore, has been one of the largest tech hubs in the world. We have over 1 million tech workers in the city of Bangalore, and in the city of almost 13 million people, 1 million are tech workers. We are catering to various segments. We are not just looking into the issue of automation and back office, but also there has been cutting edge design which has been taken up in the field of automobiles, say by Daimler-Benz, in the field of aerospace, like that of Airbus and Boeing, and in the field of AI and IoT by the IBM, Intel, and a number of others. So we have been continuously working with the industry to see how the skills can be augmented. One, number two is how the skilled manpower can be augmented. And for that, we have different programs. We are reaching out, say, for example, for the aerospace sector, for the biotechnology sector, reaching out to the colleges and institutions, running programs together with the conventional degree programs, which are vocational programs more required for the likes of the industry, working with them. To cite an example, yesterday I was talking to Bosch, and Bosch is working with 25 of our institutions to see how skilled manpower can be generated required by them. There are companies like Dynamatic who are working on the aerospace sector. Likewise, we have Dassault, which is again a French company, working with us on aerospace. So we are looking at advanced manufacturing. We are working with several of the companies to see how their addresses can be, needs can be addressed. So we would like greater collaboration and also partnership to understand what exactly are the specific needs. And we have our colleagues in various ministries and departments, and we would work jointly with them to ensure
we tackle the
skill gap, if any.
Strengthening the workforce.
Fantastic. Thank you, Principal Secretary. If I have time for just one more question, I know that we're going to hear next from the incoming president of PAFI, Ishtiaq Amjad, who is with Coca-Cola. And Coca-Cola, of course, is one of the big FMCG brands in Bangalore. And, you know, you talked about increasingly focusing as well, not just on the knowledge economy, but also on the FMCG sector as well. Can you talk to us about some of the things that you're doing to really advance and add to the ease of doing business, particularly, you know, in the FMCG sector? And I know that you talked about some additional moves that, that the government is making on the ease of doing business.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Karnataka is focusing on strengthening of skills of our workforce so that the industries get a quality manpower easily. So that's also we are thinking, and whatever facilities you require, we definitely will do it. And please come back and invest in Karnataka.
Thank you, Honorable Chief Minister. And Rahul, shall I hand it over to you, or shall I hand it back to Ishtiaq?
Ishtiaq would be better.
Thank you.
All yours.
Thank you, Rahul. Thank you, Nisha. Thank you, Mr. Gaurav. First of all, thank you very much. We cannot tell you how happy we are to have you as a partner state. If you really look at the theme of this year's PAFI National Forum, it is building trust and charting growth. We could not have asked for a better partner state, a state that we trust absolutely blindly to anything that we do, and we have never been let down ever in our entire in our entire career. And of course, you know, I mean, charting growth, there is Karnataka is and will always probably remain one of the beacon of growth as far as the state development is concerned. Personally, for my company, Coca-Cola, as you know, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Minister, and Gaurav, sir, you are aware very well, we have our the home of our largest bottling partner, Hindustan Coca-Cola, in Bangalore. We have some world-class manufacturing facilities in Bidadi. And in my own career of last 20-odd year, the maximum number of factories that I have been instrumental in investing has always been in Karnataka. So this is a singular privilege for me in my individual capacity as the President of the Public Affairs Forum of India, and also as the representative of Coca-Cola.
I think, Rahul, we lost Ishtiaq. Maybe you could wind up and just tell everybody to join back at 5 p.m. for the next session.
Okay. So really sorry about this. I think it's a technology hitch that's happened. But on behalf of PAFI, on behalf of Ishtiaq, on behalf of all the delegates and all the participants in this conference, I'd like to thank you, Honorable Chief Minister, Honorable Minister, Mr. Gupta, for joining us today. It's been just marvelous to hear from all of you to understand what Karnataka has to offer. It's been quite an experience for all of us actually who do business with Karnataka, because we just keep going. Sorry, Ishtiaq, you're back. I was about to finish off, but you want to sort of wrap it up?
I just wanted to thank one thing. Sorry for the network issue.
Yeah.
Any last word from you, the Honorable Chief Minister, and we can close.
I think, Ishtiaq, thank you so much. It's been absolutely a wonder to interact with all of you. As Honorable Chief Minister Sir has indicated, we look forward to working with PAFI. We wish you all the best in your 10th year celebrations now. and look forward to working from you, hearing from you, and building up the economy together. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Can all participants,
things are better,
please?
Maybe we could have a physical meeting with you, and all of us would be delighted to come to beautiful city of Bengaluru. Thank you so much, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. We can close the call.
Yeah. Request all the participants to come back at 5. Thank you.
Thank you, Nisha.
Thanks, Nisha.
Thank you, Nisha.
Thanks, Ajay.